and girls, ground flying, poison, bug water, electric rock, grass, dark ice, normal fire, fighting still, psychic fairy.
Hey everybody, Swonic here. Today is the first episode of Unova Unveiled. One better way to start it off is with the first Pokemon in the Unova Dex, which also happens to be a legendary Pokemon. Welcome to the Dexperts' very first legendary episode with Pokemon 000. It's Victini! Victini is a psychic and fire type legendary Pokemon that came from the Unova region. Victini is said to bring victory to the trainer that befriends it. It produces an infinite amount of energy within itself and can share it with others by touch. The energy it produces can grant the Pokemon immense strength and can give people super jumps. It can also become invisible. As shown in white, Victini Zekrom, and black, Victini and Reshiram, it can send visions to people via telepathy. It's also been shown to enjoy eating macarons, although it sometimes chokes on them. Victini's appearance seems to be based on Usagi Ringo, a method of cutting apple slices to make him look similar to rabbits. Conceptually, it might draw inspiration from Nike, the Greek winged goddess of victory, or Victoria, another winged goddess of victory from Rome. In fact, Victini's tail wings are a reference to both goddesses. Its theme of V can be derived from the Roman numeral for 5, as in Generation 5. It also stands for victory. The V shape it makes with its hand don't just symbolize victory, but it also symbolizes peace. Victini's name may be a combination of victory, destiny, tini, or tiny. His Japanese name, Bukitini, is derived from the same thing. And now for the legendary only segment where I share the Pokemon's lore. It's PokéLore! Years ago, people have heard of Victini's power for bringing them victory in any kind of competition, which turned them greedy. Until one super rich person befriended Victini. He then bought an entire island and built a lighthouse on top of it, which would later be known as Liberty Garden. Under the lighthouse lies a secret room where Victini can live in solitude and hide from the greedy humans. No one has ever seen it since, and has now been dismissed as a mythical Pokemon. Well, that's the game's lore. Now how about the anime's lore from the Victini movies? Victini once lived alongside the King of the People of the Vale in the Kingdom of the Vale. The kingdom prospered due to the king's control over the Dragon Force, which can create habitable environments for people and Pokemon. The king also had two twin brothers, who each possessed the legendary dragons of Unova, Zekrom and Reshiram. Soon, the twin brothers waged war on each other, which threatened the entire kingdom. The outcome? Both sides sustained heavy losses, and the dragons reverted to their dormant stages in the end. The war turned the Dragon Force into a violent, destructive energy that can destroy the entire planet. The king borrowed Victini's power to strengthen the power of the Psychic-type Pokemon living in the castle to move the entire castle to a safe place to lock away the destructive Dragon Force, which would later be known as Aindok Town. After moving the castle successfully and saving the planet, the king warned Victini if the castle was moved again, the Dragon Force would be unleashed once again and will destroy the entire planet. Victini was first shown in a preview for the 14th Pokemon movie at the end of Zork, Master of Illusions. Victini's Unova Pokedex number is 000, making it the first Pokemon to legitimately have the number 000 in any Pokedex listing. Victini is the only Pokemon to be listed before the starter Pokemon of its native region. Consequently, Victini is the only mythical Pokemon of a later generation to appear next to a mythical Pokemon of an early generation in the natural Pokedex. Although Victini has a shiny sprite, Pokemon Black and White are programmed so that shiny Victini cannot be encountered. It shares this trait with Zekrom and Reshiram. This is called the Shiny Lock. According to an IGN interview, Victini is Junichi Masuda's favorite Generation 5 Pokemon. Victini was designed by Mata Ilbi. It was meant to appeal more to girls than to boys. In Black and White 2, if Victini was taken to Liberty Garden, it would come out of its Pokeball and dance around happily. All of Victini's stats are all well-rounded, with each stat having 100 each, so I recommend a mixed set. Get a docile nature one and super train it in both attack and special attack. For stat moves, I recommend one of his signature moves, Searing Shot and Zed Headbutt. For the last two slots, I recommend Wild Charge to defend against water types, and Energy Ball to defend against rock and ground types, and make sure he's holding a life orb. And now, here are some random tips on how to train your Victini. Victini has a special event only move, and that's V-Create, which does physical damage, but at lower speed after each use. If you do have a V-Create Victini, make sure to also know his Trick Room. Victini can even learn Fusion Flare, Fusion Bolt, Blue Flare, Bull Strike, and Glacier through special events. How about a Victini with Trick while holding a choice item? Flame Charge can increase your speed with every use. And finally, Dazzling Gleam to defend against Dark types. And that's it! Victini, the Pokemon will always have first place. Stay tuned for the next Unova Unveil episode, it's all about Serperior. If you like this video, like, comment, and subscribe, and be sure to share this with your friends as well. Alright, see ya!